Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome a former WWE champion, four-time WCW champion, and one of the most influential and charismatic superstars in the history of the WWE, Kevin Nash!
Well, there he is, ladies and gentlemen, invited here tonight by our Chief Operating Officer, Triple H.
That's kind of funny. You know, this is two of our events in a row that Kevin Nash has been invited to by Triple H.
Kevin Nash, 6'11", 315 pounds. He was the longest reigning WWE champion of the 1990s.
Whoa. I've known Kevin for about 20 years. He's very outspoken, and this should be most interesting.
I'd first off like to thank my friend Triple H for giving me a chance to come here tonight and explain last night's actions. For you that don't know, Triple H and I have been close friends for almost 20 years. He's also the godfather to my son. Last night, I asked Triple H if I could attend SummerSlam. He said, "Yeah, I'll send you some tickets. There'll be a will call." So, I was watching right before the main event. I got a text. The text read, "Hey, big man, could you do me a favor? No matter what happens in the main event, stick the winner for me. Hey, when a friend asks me to do something, I do it. The thing was, it'd been a long time since I've been in the ring. And I missed it. The thrill that I got at the Rumble, I'll never forget. So what I did last night, CM Punk, was business. Pure and simple. Now the thing is, I get to the building, I find out that Triple H says he knows nothing about it. I think we need to get on the same page, Triple H. Come on, buddy. That's it, just business."
Well, can you say unfinished business, perhaps?
This is gonna be good. There's the man, Kevin Nash, quote, stuck last night. Former WWE champion, CM Punk.
What about it? You got buying what we just heard from Kevin Nash?
What do you believe? Kevin Nash and Triple H?
Okay, you expect me to believe that load of crap? You expect me to believe that you and Triple H aren't on the same page? You guys are best friends. You know, for weeks I've been hearing Triple H is gonna do what's right for business. He re-signed me because it's good for business. And you're just gonna do whatever your best friend asks you to do? Don't really answer this, it's a rhetorical question. If Triple H asked you to jump off a bridge, would you? Because I think that would be good for business. CM Punk! CM Punk! CM Punk! CM Punk! I've always had a sneaking suspicion that Triple H doesn't really know what's good for business. And I've always heard that Kevin Nash doesn't really know what's good for business. And now I know, I've seen it. The proof is here, right now, standing in the ring. You have no idea what's good business.
This is the first time you and I have spoke. And let me tell you something. You need to watch your mouth.
I need to watch my mouth?
Yeah.
You need to watch the show. I do and say whatever I want to whomever I please.
Obviously, your world just changed.
The story you just told clearly points out that Triple H is a liar. You know, but maybe, just maybe, Triple H is telling the truth. Maybe you're the liar, Kevin Nash.
Would you like to see the text message on my telephone?
You want to see the text message my little sister Shalene sent me last night? Here it is. OMG, Kevin Nash, WTF, thought he was dead, LOL. The funny thing is, Shalene is normally wrong. And here you are, live and in living color. It's just your career that's dead, right? And see, you being out here, it doesn't so much piss me off. What you did last night pissed me off. I got a lot of people I'm pointing fingers at. There's a lot of people I'm pissed off at. Shockingly enough, Alberto Del Rio is not one of them. What he did, I did before. Eight people have cashed in briefcases. Eight people have become champion. He picked the right spot. You, what this all represents is Triple H is the new COO. So clearly, he's running amok and now he's bringing his cronies back.
All Triple H has done is shook things up around here.
No. I'm the guy that shook things up around here.
All you are is a little indie-rific, little wannabe, what? You've been here 5 years? You've been in two main events? Really? What, do you have the belt 3 times in 20 days?
Yeah, that really hurts, you know, coming from somebody who knows so much about being a main eventer. The guy that said the legendary Eddie Guerrero was a vanilla midget. What do you know about main event talent, huh? It's 2011, it's not 1994.
Well, you know, if you want to go to 1996, when I changed the business with Scott Hall and made sure that everybody, including guys like you, got guaranteed money. Yeah, thank you. That's what you should be saying. Shut your mouth. And say thank you, Mr. Nash. Because as far as I'm concerned, if this is where the business is right now, with some guy that looks like a short order cook from a Pikeville Waffle House is a champion, take a shower, hit the weights, get a clue.
I like Waffle House. I don't know what you got against Waffle House, and I don't know what you have against me, but last night, you did something you shouldn't have done. It's not good for business, Kev. You put your hands on me. Now, I may look like a short order cook. You tell me to hit the weights. I'd rather have walked in to this company, CM Punk, and leave CM Punk than to show up somewhere as Oz or Vinny Vegas or Big Daddy Cool Diesel. You know what? Enough with the talking, enough with the snarky comments. Last night showed me that you want to fight, and trust me, I'm not scared of a fight. You want to fight? We can fight right now in San Diego.
Bring it.
Wait a minute. Doesn't feel right. Who's security guard, he knows.
I'm not surprised at all. The COO, Triple H, has deemed his buddy Kevin Nash untouchable. Because it certainly isn't me that put these security guards out here to stop me from kicking your ass. But if they're here watching your back, that means he's back there somewhere and nobody's watching his. So maybe I'll go find out from the COO myself.
Wow. I don't know about you guys, but that whole exchange just confused me even more. What is going on?
It may be confusing, but I hate to see her hear it end. I was loving it. I tell you, Kevin Nash did not sound truthful, quite frankly. Sounded like a whiner to me on some occasion. And that's not the Kevin Nash that I know. Something's wrong here. Obviously.
The following is a fatal four-way match for the World Heavyweight Championship.
Every man for himself. First man to gain pinfall or submission will win the World Heavyweight Championship.
Oh! Hey, look at this!
Oh!
The 619
from the top rope!
Oh!
Cover! He did it!
Vaya con Dios! Rey Mysterio is your new World Champion!
Can Rey Mysterio return home to the 619 and earn a 1-2-3 against the new undisputed WWE Champion, Alberto Del Rio? We're going to find out tonight in our main event live on Monday Night Raw.